bulging eyes, muscly. It is a skillful name.
我好喜欢在我们佛教呢，我们有很多诸如观音菩萨、地藏菩萨这样子非常样貌非常平静祥和的菩萨。但与此同时，我们也有这个菩提达摩的那个样子，他这个眼睛很瞪着大眼睛，然后很多的这个有很大的肌肉啊站在那里。这个其实是一种方便法门。
So please tell us, you have just a briefly process of how you learn Kung Fu. When did you get up in the morning? When did you go to sleep at night? Did your teachers, you know, give you hard time?
那请你简短的告诉我们，你是怎么学武术功夫的呢？你几点起床啊？几点睡觉？你的老师有没有对你非常严格？
在七十年代，我家里其实很穷，我从小父亲就在我两岁就过世，所以我有两个姐姐两个哥，家里太穷，所以。
So in the 70s, my family was very poor. My dad passed away when I was two, and I had two other sisters and two other brothers.
所以在我八岁的时候，他们就选了我去学武。但是我们如果能够学武学得好呢，这个。政府就会给你吃的和衣服和住的，所以怎样
？So at my age of 8 years old, my family chose me to learn martial arts because if you learn well, the government will provide for your food, shelter, and everything.
所以在我八岁的时候就练得很努力，因为家里穷，希望能够承担一些家里的负担，所以就很快我就。也许上辈子练过，反正就练，就很快九岁就成绩很好了，完了11岁就拿冠军了。
So when I was 8 years old, I really strived very hard because my family was poor and I wanted to relieve the family's burden. And maybe I learned Kung Fu for many lifetimes. So very quickly, I picked it up and at the age of 11, I got a champion.
Yeah. 对，小时候基本上就从9岁、10岁开始就每天8个小时的训练。
Since I was 9 and 10 years old, I would practice 8 hours a day.
Yeah, 没有文化学习，每天就是8个小时的，从 morning 从最早到晚上都是训练。
I had no, cultural learning of culture from morning to night. I just practiced 8 hours every day.
因为太苦了，练的。
Because it was too tough to train.
到我30多岁的时候，还经常做噩梦。
Even when I was in my 30s, I still often had nightmares.
对啊，那个教练还是起来练功，练功。
I would still dream of my coach, waking me up and asking me to practice.
但是我很感恩这个国家培养了我，完了以后有机会也代表中国去了70年代的时候，就1974年到79年，我去过全世界40多个国家去表演武术。
But I was also very grateful for the national coach for teaching me. And even in the 70s, between 1974 to 1979, I represented China to visit more than 40 countries to perform.
但我觉得最开心的就是从小因为练武术，你就开始觉得我要进攻，我要防守，进攻防守，所以对阴和阳就有了一个基本的认识。
But the happiest for me is that in practicing Kung Fu or Wushu, I have to always think about attack and defend, attack and defend. And in a sense, in that, it grounds me with the basic understanding of yin and yang.
所以从小在我的观念里头就是说，这个世界上没有一个100%的好，也没有一个100%的坏，因为那个阴和阳里的白里头有个黑，黑里头有个白，所以他们永远都在改变当中。
And since young, at a young age, I already kind of knew that there's no 100% right or 100% wrong, good or bad, because it's always yin yang. Within black, there's white. Within white, there's black. They're always shifting and changing.
对，因为你像11岁的一个孩子，你中国那个年代，70年代，只有一个雪糕，就一个汽水，说这是最好的。但是你到了美国，哇！30多种汽水，30多种雪糕，你说这不好？哦 ，I need to think about it.
就70年代的。
Sorry.
教你。
So when I was 11, I think about it in China in the 17th, you think that, oh, if you can have, you have one type of ice cream and one type of like cola, and that was like really great. But when you go to the US, they have 30 different kinds of ice cream and 30 different kinds of soft drinks, and can you say it's not good?
I cannot say it, but I can think it.
I 我不能说，但是我心里想的是。
Sorry, 啊，呀，所以因为知道世界上不完全好和不完全坏，这个帮着我对认识生命有很大的帮助。
Because I realized that in this world you cannot say that anything is altogether good or altogether bad. That helps me to understand more about life.
所以我想更进一步的从太极去再往后找，找到无极。
So I wanted to explore within the Taoist Tai Chi and found to look for what is behind it, Wu Ji, which is kind of like boundless, that which is without boundary.